Hello, my dear friends. Today I want to share with you how to make standing collar. And when you cut applied interfacing and stitch both sides of your collar, you need to work on the ends of the collar. And if it's rounded like mine, you need to cut one allowance very close to the seam and cut small notches around the second allowance. In this way, you will be able to iron and press and form very nice, beautiful rounded shape. And then you will need to make a top stitching just 1 millimeter away of the seam on the side of the inner collar. This will help to form this beautiful kind of like a rib line in the top of the collar. Then fold your garment exactly a half and make small notches in the center of your collar and in the center of the back detail of your garment. And then we will pin the inner part of your collar to the wrong side of your garment, center to center. Also, I will attach the area where the shoulder seams are ending. And when you attaching the end of the collar to the front panel, the collar will be little overlapping, you see the front panel. So in this way, your stitching lines will be actually crossing exactly at the center of the front panel. I will also attach a hanger to this garment, but just particular in this design. Of course, if you are making shirts or blouses, you do not need it. Before stitching, I also will double check that shoulder seams are located in a symmetrically from the both sides, and I will stitch with a 1 centimeter or a half of an inch allowance. Of course, with the back stitching in the beginning and at the end of the stitching. And I will also make few times a back stitching at the area where the ends of the hanger are located. And now we can see that the center of the front panel comes exactly to the end of the collar stand. And then I will iron around the seam. And I will press the allowances of this seam towards to the collar. In this way, the allowances will be hidden inside of the collar. And then I will fold allowances of the collar around of the center of the front part of our garment. And then I will fold and press the allowances of the upper collar, making sure that the folding line goes exactly in the top of the stitching line of the lower collar. And in this part, please make sure that you take your time and you iron it exactly correctly in the top of the stitching line. Because if you do it correctly, it will be very easy to stitch it with the top stitching with the very first try and finish the collar very fast. After ironing, double check it everything, and if everything looks good, you are ready to go stitch it. Okay, and now is the last part of the stitching. We need to make a top stitching. Just 1 millimeter away from the folding line, or it will be 1/16 of an inch. And while stitching, we need to make sure that all the time the folding line of the upper collar laying on exactly on the seam of attaching lower collar to the garment. And voila, you can see everything beautiful, everything absolutely straight from one side and from the inner side, from the wrong side. Looks nice. Sometimes it can slide, so do not afraid you. Sometimes we need to fix it if something's wrong. But in this type of fabric, it probably will be easier for you to make it from the very first try. And then we will iron. We will put our stand collar already like standing up, and we can iron all fabric around. And also we will need to iron the collar itself, making sure that you put the collar exactly at the edge of the ironing board, and this way you will not accidentally press any unwanted folds on the main garment. And that's it, it's ready. We can now attach sleeves and make buttons, and our garment will be ready. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I wish you good luck, and looking forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye bye.